Today we discuss the story B. Wordsworth, written by V.S. Naipaul. B. Wordsworth appears in Naipaul's Miguel Street, which is a collection of linked short stories, with each story focusing on a single character. B. Wordsworth is a Calypsonian poet who befriends the narrator, a young, impressionable and inquisitive boy. The story is written with the aim of motivating the reader to appreciate poetry and beauty in the nature that surrounds us. The story is told by an unnamed child narrator who lives in Miguel Street. His house is frequented by three beggars: a dhoti-clad Indian at 10, a woman smoking pipe at 12 o'clock, and a blind man led by a boy at 2. The strangest caller is a smartly dressed person who comes at about 4 o'clock one afternoon, wishing to watch the narrator's bees. Thus, we are introduced to the man of the story, B. Wordsworth. The narrator's mother is quite suspicious of the man and gives him the cold shoulder. She instructs the narrator to watch the man while he watches the bees, and the two end up watching the bees together, squatting under a palm tree for about an hour. The little boy is intrigued by the man's appearance and seeks to know him better. The man introduces himself. He said he is a poet and the greatest in the world. Then the boy asked his name. He said, B. Wordsworth. He tells that the B in his name stands for black, and that White Wordsworth was his brother. Wordsworth then tries to sell a poem to the kid for 4 cents, only to end up getting chased by his mother. He calmly accepts the unappreciative response as the poet's tragedy and doesn't seem to mind it at all. Perhaps he has been through such rejections earlier. A week later, the narrator meets B. Wordsworth at the corner of Miguel Street. He hasn't sold any poems yet, but invites the narrator to his home in Alberto Street to feast on mangoes, which have become red, ripe and juicy. The two head for B. Wordsworth's one-roomed hut, which looks rather wild, surrounded by a mango, a coconut and a plum tree. The narrator hawks down 6 mangoes and ends up staining his shirt with the mango juice. He gets thrashed by his mother on reaching home and runs away to B. Wordsworth's house. Mr. B. comforts him and takes him for a walk down St. Clair Avenue to the Savannah and then to the race course. B. Wordsworth then suggests lying on the grass and gazing at the sky, and the boy did as he told him. And the boy saw what he meant. He felt like nothing, and at the same time he had never felt so big and great in all his life. The boy forgot all his anger and all his tears and all his blows. Wordsworth then teaches him the names of the constellations, of which he seems particularly remember the Orion. Shortly, they are interrupted by a policeman and the interrogation becomes a comic exchange. The policeman said, "What are you doing here?" Verse was said, I have been asking myself the same question for 40 years. The two become fast friends. The narrator starts visiting Wordsworth's home very often and one day asks him, why is it that he lets the bushes abound in his house? The poet then tells him a little story which completely overwhelms the kid.